Hi, today I work on the backpack. I asked the person who asked me to do this piece to send me some photos of the backpack that he wants on here, and so I got a bunch of those pictures and a little more detail on exactly how it's attached to the straps and things like that. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I can't do the clothes till I get the backpack done, because the clothes will react to the straps of the backpack and all that stuff. And so I've got to do that first. Now at times this is going to be in the way, but there's nothing I can do about that. All right, where do I start, Peg? Her hair goes down quite a ways. It actually goes way down to her shoulder. I'm going to block in her hair a little bit better. I'll put detail into it later. I've got the top, put a cap on her, so I'm just sort of holding off on the hair until I get ready to do that. There's stress wrinkles from where the strap attaches to the pack. I'm not going to go into great detail, but I've got to put at least a basic detail showing weight and the reason I'm working on her shoulder. Have something for the strap to sit on. And so I've got to at least fill that in. Okay, the backpack has a lower area for, I think, bag, and this is a bag up here, and they're both separated, but they have different shapes to them, so, and they also have weather protective flaps over their zippers, so I gotta do that too. And if I have to, I'll carve away the foam underneath, but right now, I don't think I have to do that. Now, the only reason the backpack might be filled out heavily is if there was a lot of stuff in it. And so I'm just going to assume that she would not pack light. Well, she'd pack lightly, but she would more than likely have a lot of stuff in the backpack. I'm going to have to smooth this out the best I can with lighter fluid, which means it's going to delay getting things done because I got to stop working on that part for at least a half hour or so while the damn stuff evaporates. But I got to do it. I can't do it after I put the strap on. Whole thing I'm doing on this is high detail in the face, where the portrait really is, and nice smooth texture every place else. Now there's a little bit of a hole area there, and I can't do anything until this stuff evaporates to fill that in, and all I can do is just do the best I can. Let's see. Ah, there it is. When you watch my videos, you'll see me working real fast. In actuality, half my time's looking for things. Okay, this just smooths it off a little bit more. Hitting it with a flame changes the texture just a little bit. Okay, got one. So what you see me doing fast is actually taking maybe a half hour, 10 minutes, 5 minutes, and I just did this too soon because now it's hot and melted from the flame, so I gotta wait for that to cool off. I just screwed it up. Now, I'll have to come back in about a half hour. Right now, I think I'll work on some other part while I'm waiting for that to cool off. Now I'm editing this so that you can see that I'm doing it right away, so you're not sitting there for 10-15 minutes while I'm looking for tools and heating things up. Now I'm just cutting the top of her head off because I've got to make a hat, and And the way I make my hats, I cut the top of the head off, and you'll see why. Damn, knife cools off real quick. Gives me the size of the brim of the hat, and I can draw my pattern for the brim that goes around her face and around her head using the shape of her head. I'll put that back on for now, but that's going to be taken off in a few minutes. So the video that you watch on YouTube, it ends up being about 15, 20 minutes long, or even 10 minutes long. In reality, it's probably 4 or 5 hours long making, because I had to stop and look for a tool or get ready to do a particular thing on the sculpture. So don't think that I'm all that fast. I'm not. Actually pretty slow. And that crackling noise, that metal noise, is actually my heater. It's not warm outside, it's down in the teens. And there's a slight breeze, so it's probably in the below zero with the wind chill factor right now. Not complaining. I live in Montana. I don't expect it to be anything but cold. Okay. One hole. I've got to do another hole. Not quite as big. That's even smaller. So those of you beginners who are watching me sculpt and you're thinking maybe I'd like to do this too, but I'll never be as fast as this guy. Well, I'm not that fast. I just hide the fact that I'm slow. I can't tell if I'm covering this up with a post or my hands, but I hope I'm not obstructing too much, because I can't look at the camera and look at my hands too. There we go. So if you're a sculptor and you're doing clothes or you're doing things like this, you literally have to become a seamstress, because you're building something that is made out of fabric. And recognize if you do it right. There. You try to build up the division. Not sure exactly what that is, but using leftover clay that I used on the flap. There we go. Now it's just a matter of filling in between two pieces of clay. Need a softer piece. Now I gotta also fill underneath this flap, because I gotta be able to cast it without causing a lot of expense. Actually, it's starting to look like the backpack. Wow. I'm good. Goes up under here. I'm not sure exactly what it does, because I don't have the backpack here, so I can't. I'm just guessing here. And it's going to be the same over here, so I've got to put the same strap over here. Goes over the end of this strap and it connects to that seam. All right. There's a pocket type. Seam. Yeah. Now it's a netting, but I have no way of making it look like netting, so I'm not going to worry about that. Fill that in, but not right now. Make sure I got the same angle or same height, I mean. Seems looks good. All right, that's it for today. A lot of technical stuff. I'm not wild about technical stuff, but this was kind of fun because it was different than what I normally do. And because of that, it made it interesting. All right, good night, and I'll see you next time.
Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right, see you next time.